So this is lesson 4 of the series Demystifying Compilers. We are going to see the Semantic Analyzer today. This is a channel beats in alta velocidade. So let's recapitulate. We saw in previous lessons that the phases of compilation are formed by the following steps: lexical analysis, syntactic analysis, semantic analysis, and code generation and optimization. We studied the first two steps, lexical and syntactic analysis. After the syntactic analysis, we reach a step where all lexemes are valid, successfully mapped into tokens, and the sequence of tokens is correct. On this stage, is the program okay to compile? The answer is no, not yet. For achieving this, we must traverse the semantic analysis phase. So, the last step before any code generation or optimization is the semantic analysis. It checks if whether or not there is a consistency on the usage of type declarations and type expressions. A stream of tokens can pass through the lexical and the syntactic analysis and still not be compilable. Example given, this one here. What is the problem we have here? We declared variables x, y, and z as character values, but they are assigned to integer values returned by the nextInt method. Notice that there is nothing wrong with the lexemes or the order in which the tokens are written, but we still have a compilation problem. All the expressions on a stream of code must have expected types. Example given, inside an if statement there must be a boolean expression. Inside a loop condition there also must be a boolean expression. All sub-expressions of an expression must be of the same type, and so on. So, the code below is not correctly typed because it invokes scanner.nextInt as an expression to x and y, and these two variables were declared as char, a different type from that one returned by scanner.nextInt. It would have passed from the syntactic analysis phase, but it is still not compilable. For expressions where variable names are used, it is checked if their types that were stored on the symbol table correspond to the operations that are used on the expression. So, let's consider again the LL1 version of the grammar of the subset of Java of the previous lessons. This one shown here. Now let's consider the following token stream: int x, int y equals 0, and x equals y plus 2 plus 4 plus the string beats in alta velocidade. We can see that there is a type error on the previous assignment on variable x, but how is it detected by the semantic analyzer? First of all, we know that the lexical analyzer creates a symbol table for the declared variables when checking the validity of each lexeme on the token stream. So, this is our symbol table here, lexemes x and y, type int for both, and scope local for both. So, what is done here is the following. The type of each sub-expression is inherited on the tree that represents the expression. If there is a combination of operator and sub-expressions that do not match the expected type, then there is a type error. Let's see this process in practice. So, in the case of expression y plus 2 plus 4 plus the string beats in alta velocidade, we can see that there is a sub-expression in which there is a string operand and an integer operand being applied to the operator plus. But operator plus in Java can be used for two string operands, or for two int, float, or double operands, but not for a string operand and other operand of other type. Thus, in the case below, we have a type error. We say that the plus operator is an overloaded operator because it can be applied to two string operands and two double, float, and int operands. When used with two strings, plus is a concatenation, and when used with int, float, or double, plus is an algebraic sum between the operands. On the other expression, now we have an integer expression. As it occurs on the declarative assignment int y equals 0, then the semantic analyzer must see on the symbol table what is the type of y and check if it matches the type of the expression. In our case, it does, so there is no type error here. So let's change our program in order to make it become correctly typed. Our change program is the following. Int x into I equals 0 and x receives an x being assigned to y plus 2 plus 4 plus 7. So, why is it correctly typed? We see that operator plus applied to 4 and 7 is a sum between integers, so no type error until here. It returns another integer value, and this result is the second parameter of the sum operator, whose left operand is 2. Again, no type error here. And again, an integer value is returned. The result is the second parameter of the sum operator, whose left side is y, whose type is integer, as checked in the symbol table. So again, no type error here. As the final result of this expression is an integer, then we must check on the symbol table if it matches the type of integer x. We see that it does, so expression is correctly typed and compilable. Now all lexemes are valid, successfully mapped into tokens, the sequence of tokens is correct, and the program is well typed. Is the program okay to compile? The answer is yes, it is compilable. It is okay to compile. So in the next lesson we will explore code generation. Thank you very much, subscribe to the channel, like the video, push the little bell such that you receive notifications for my new videos, and make questions and suggestions on the comments.